Okay.
So.
Now you're Joanna.
Rupert, how's your day?
Wonderful.
Thank you for meeting me.
Of course.
So today, today's agenda is to mainly follow up with the previous requests about your thoughts in terms of the, our A&M's strategy in Indonesia.
Okay.
And maybe follow up with your decision last time.
And my decision, just so we're on the same page, was to pursue an organic growth.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And so the other purpose I was hoping of this meeting to kind of go over my role going forward in the company.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's also on the agenda.
Yes, definitely.
Okay, cool. So should we start with maybe we should start with that to get that behind us before we go on at how we're going to pursue our duties in Indonesia?
So what I have in mind is that since you're definitely experts in terms of Indonesian markets, we definitely value your idea, opinions, and thoughts. So in term, I think this is a great opportunity for you to stay in the company and use your strength in terms of market knowledge. So I think your role and the future strategy will go hand in hand. So we could start with what you think about your role in the future will be, and in terms of how would that be related to the company strategy in terms of the organic role. And since we also asked other people's idea, it seems that some concern is that organic role is too difficult. So some other people, they also talk about a potential acquisition in the Indonesia market.
Okay.
That's also, we would like to get your thoughts and see how you can get involved in this process.
Okay. So. For me, I feel like I've been with the company for a long time, and I've developed a good expertise in the Indonesian market, and I want to be a part of the team, and I want to be a part of the company going forward. However, it's important to me to feel like I am still growing professionally, and so I've been in this role for the past, I think, 10 years. And it's important for me to continue to get more responsibility and to be able to grow within the company, even if it's not with a title.
Mm-hmm.
So, first I'd like to make sure that whatever strategy we choose to implement in Indonesia, that I'm able to really, for instance, be on the ground in Indonesia, being responsible for implementing the project.
Okay, sounds good. That's actually in line with what we're thinking as well. Since we really appreciate your long-term stay within the company, so we're actually thinking in a very fast way to offer you a good position in Indonesia. So we're actually thinking maybe do a acquisition, and then we'll be able to send you to lead the business over there so that you can actually stay with your family in Indonesia, as well as maintaining your current salary raise. Since we understand that the job market in Indonesia may not be as competitive as in Singapore, so we're willing to offer you a attractive packages you're getting now, as well as putting you closer to your family in Indonesia.
Okay. Sounds like we're close. Now, a few concerns I have with what you said. First of all, it means a lot to my family to be closer to them. It was very difficult to have the conversation with them.
Yeah.
That I was not going to automatically get to move back. I think we can get to maybe the strategy in a minute, but of acquisition or organic. But as far as pay, now if I do move to Indonesia and I do take on more responsibility, and I do, for instance, lead a company that has been acquired, I would assume that would come with a raise.
So we understand that. Since however, there are two concerns here. So first of all, if we're acquiring an Indonesian company,
mm-hmm.
and then it's since Indonesian average salary is generally only 50% of the one that you probably get in Singapore.
Mm-hmm.
So if we acquire a new company and then send you over there to take the lead, you already have a salary advantage compared to most of the staffs in that company already. So we don't want to create such a huge gap between your salary and the other management team of the acquired company. And we also want to use this first year as a testing window and see how it goes. Of course, our company value meritocracy, and if the company performed well, we definitely could negotiate or talk about salary in the later stage. However, I think as of right now, keeping a Singapore salary level is really a competitive advantage for you to be in Indonesia.
So,
okay.
I don't know.
I understand, but I just wonder if the company is taking advantage of me in a way, because I have a specific expertise and background and capable of leading a company in Indonesia.
Yeah.
And if I wasn't a part of the company, how much would it a replacement for me with Singapore experience at corporate and willing to go live in Indonesia cost the company?
Yeah, so I can imagine the cost would be similar, sending some other people in Indonesia. However, we definitely value your expertise in the market, but it's a matter of time to prove the success of the company. Otherwise, it will be very difficult for us to justify the raise. Since in the past we haven't seen a significant improvement in our Indonesian business. So given this lack of evidence or lack of proof for success in the future, because in the past we haven't seen this pattern, so we would like to maybe have 1 year to test the result first before we can actually justify the raise of salary.
So if I understand you correctly, you're asking me or giving me the opportunity to take on more responsibility, right? To have basically the leeway to be the decision maker in Indonesia, non-strategy. The strategy will still be as a team. I agree that experience as well, but that doesn't come with, we can't agree on any kind of compensation.
So again, I think compensation definitely will come only after we see improvement in the business. So we do want to give you more responsibility, because in the future we feel like maybe the lack of improvement in Indonesia business is because that we didn't give enough authority to you to execute and to use your strength and knowledge. So that's something, also a chance for you to prove yourself. And after that, we are confident to propose to the CEO and say, look, Uber is really good and he's bringing a lot of revenue and business to our company, then we can justify the raise of compensation.
Okay, I understand. But so maybe we can figure out other ways too. So for instance, you mentioned the CEO. Is there a way we can, if I relocate to Jakarta, I could come back quarterly and have updates with both you and the CEO, so I can progress my career and have FaceTime with yourself and with the CEO?
Definitely.
I think that would be great. So quarterly updates with FaceTime, in person with CEO.
Yeah. We can definitely do that.
Okay. And so relocation is a given, right, to Jakarta?
Yes,
we agree.
You will be close to your family, that's for sure.
Okay. And I would be leading the effort on the ground.
Yes.
So, and as far as leading the effort, and I assume this is all, you know, local non-strategic decisions. How about strategic decisions? Because it's going to be tough to lead a company and be leading one way and then just, you know, get an email from your team saying we've completely made a right turn. Like, can I be also involved in some of the strategic decision making?
Yes, we will definitely value your decision making, your idea in terms of where we should go in the Indonesian market. So during your quarterly or monthly in-person meeting, definitely we could talk about what you think about the market and incorporate your idea and thoughts into the headquarters decision making.
Okay, so as far as compensation, I understand your viewpoint in that you need to take a wait and see approach. So, fine, I don't expect a raise right off the bat. I mean, I think I can make that argument, but I see your point as well. I think my concern is that the success of this strategy has a lot to do with a lot of factors that aren't necessarily in my, that I can't know. Right? So can we, if I am able to, instead of saying let's reassess in a year, can we somehow put an incentive package for incentive-based pay for this year? So if the company, let's say, turns a improves their, let's say, net income, operating income by, you know, 3 to 5%, then I get to have a bonus or a certain bonus fee.
Understood.
So that I have guarantee that a year from now you guys were like, oh, that wasn't quite what we were thinking, let's talk again in another year.
Okay, so our company hasn't actually tried this model yet.
Mm-hmm.
So this is something I think is also interesting, and I probably will bring it to the CEO's meeting and see what he thinks, because I'm not really in this position to make this kind of high-level decision.
Okay.
So it will be very difficult for me to guarantee right now, but I definitely will bring it to the meeting to talk about it with CEO.
Okay. Well, I understand that you need sign off and input from the CEO. But for me to commit to anything, you know, I think that would need to, I would need that information. So, I mean, we can leave it as pending agreement on bonus structure. I don't know.
Yeah, it could be. So,
who is your favorite?
So what would you be comfortable with presenting to the CEO? As far as the bonus structure.
So I will tell him what you just told me and see how he feels about it.
Okay. So, I mean, I would think we would come up with 2 to 3 levers.
You don't like
you know, if let's say we're acquiring a company, it's the ability to retain the talent, to some kind of income target, and let's say market share, and then each of those being, let's say, a 10% bonus if we hit those targets.
That's also interesting. However, if there's this such incentive program, I could imagine our CFO or CEO, they will argue back that if the business is not doing as well as the projected or industry average, you'll probably put yourself in a more dangerous position if you're trying to argue this compensation structure.
Right, so the targets could be, you know, what the targets are would be beneficial and would be targets that the company that they would be happy with and that I would be happy with, right?
Okay. So what you're saying is if you exceed the targets, or you're setting your target for, or are you just setting a target that you want to hit for a profit sharing incentive program?
Well, I would have, we're setting a target that I have that to hit or exceed.
Okay. So what I was saying is, since Indonesia is a relatively volatile market, and there's of course up and down that you cannot control, my concern is that if our acquired company won't be able to reach the targets, and then you're asking for this type of profit sharing incentive, the company, the headquarter may think that you deserve a cut if the company's underperformed. So I just really think this is a dangerous thing to propose, since you're putting yourself at risk with this sort of performance.
Yeah, but you know, I think we agreed to sit down a year from now and reassess what the market did. We're all professionals here. Why it happened? What were the reasons? Was it the company's fault? Was it not? And then reassess the compensation in a year.
It's just very difficult to separate. If the company performed well, then the argument could also be because the economic as well. So it will be very difficult to separate this personal effort versus the overall industry trend. And I think right now this is right now it's very complicated to gauge this risk involved. So I think after 1 year, again, after we understand this market better, I think it will be in a much better position to talk about more incentive structure.
Okay, so you're now saying you don't think there should be a bonus structure?
I just think there's risk that you should also concern, not just because there's upside and you're also signing up for a downside.
Okay, well I just...
And also in particular, if CEO is not happy with the performance in Indonesia, and potentially what if he wants to stop the business? And as you know, the job market in Indonesia, they're not as good as in Singapore.
Right.
If you have to leave or stop your position in Indonesia, then your downside is really big.
Right, but that's
50%
my
cuts.
So that's my point. So
yeah.
If I go to Indonesia,
yeah,
and I take on a business that is very volatile and is quite risky, and then there's a chance in a year from now that my performance and my reputation take a hit, to me that deserves compensation. That I have to do something to offset that risk. Otherwise, well, it's not really, that's
yeah.
Much more safe for me to stay here.
Of course, it's also your personal choice. We offer this opportunity for you to, first of all, be closer to your family, and second, to be able to
my point is
take on a bigger role to prove yourself. So this is something that I think you will value. Of course, you could choose to stay in Singapore and do the current job. However, I feel like you will be better off with your expertise there. So that's something actually
How would the company be better off? I mean, the company needs me there too. I know you guys are helping me out, but I'm also helping you out.
Exactly. So, however, we also have some other people. They may take longer time to get the knowledge and get training. However, we do have other staff who will be willing to move to Indonesia. I just think you're the best candidate, of course. So we would like to, we'll propose this opportunity to you first, and definitely it's a personal choice, and that's why we're sitting here today.
Okay, but no return as far as the risk I'm taking to go there.
After some period of time, and when we see the business on track, and when we see your contribution to the company, definitely we can talk more about incentive program.
Okay. Well, in that case, I probably would not go.
Okay.
So.
Okay. So you stay in your current position.
For now, but you know, I would probably consider other jobs.
Okay.
As well.
Okay, sure, I understand.
Okay.
Okay.
You're great.